So I announced my intentions to create a video series examining the way women are portrayed in video games. And I was attacked by a section of male gamers. And I think part of the attack was based on their attempt to preserve the status quo of gaming as a male-dominated space and all of the privileges and entitlements that come with an unquestioned boys' club.
Tell us a little bit more about the kind of threats and attacks you received.
Sure. So all of my social media sites were flooded with sexist and racist slurs and pornography, threats to my life, threats of rape and sexual violence. The Wikipedia article about me was vandalized with sexist and racist comments and pornographic images. There were attempts made to hack into my website and into my email accounts. There were attempts made to denial of service attacks used to knock my website offline for days. Pornographic images in my likeness being raped by video game characters were created and distributed. There were attempts to collect and distribute my personal information, such as my home address and phone number. There was even a game made about me where players were invited to click on the screen, and when you did that, an image of me became increasingly battered and bruised.
It's disappointing that even...
But you didn't give up. Why?
I didn't. I think that the work that I do, sort of deconstructing female characters in popular culture and talking about how important the media is important work and really valuable.
Princess Peach is in many ways the quintessential stock character version of the damsel in distress.
I was determined to continue with my project. I also, one of the things that I did when the harassment started was I documented it and I shared some of what happened to me, because a lot of times when women talk about online harassment, they're told, well, it can't be that bad, or, you know, you're just exaggerating, or you need to grow thicker skin. And what I wanted to do, or what I hope to do by telling my story, is to create a space where people take online harassment more seriously. So the next woman that talks about her being attacked by this kind of cyber mob and this kind of large-scale harassment campaign, or even smaller levels of harassment, that she'll be taken seriously.
Yeah. What do you say about people who say, don't feed the trolls?
I think that that is a pretty good attitude to take, but I think there's a difference between not engaging one-on-one with the trolls. I think that I never spoke to any of the people harassing me directly. And, you know, so I wish to just step back for a second. There's a sort of conception that what happened to me was trolling. And trolling is largely thought of as one individual who's trying to get a rise out of another individual. And what happened to me was really a cyber mob, right? It was thousands of individuals coming after me who were loosely working together. So that's not just trying to, you know, get a rise out of someone. That's a very, you know, strategic attempt to silence and discredit an individual.
So Anita, were you surprised by the kind of support you got online from people?
I was so amazed at how much support I received. It was really encouraging. I received countless messages of support in via emails and blog posts and videos. And I think that the response to my project is actually just a small manifestation of a larger cultural shift that we're seeing in the gaming industry and in larger tech industries, where gamers of all genders are fed up with the way women are being treated and are really speaking up to demand change.